exhibition is an exploration of artistic production using the medium of buttons. And I was drawn to this concept because upon discovering several artists in the show who work with buttons, this is an underrepresented medium. With this show, we're hoping that people will look seriously at the medium of buttons and see that it is elevated to a work of art itself.
As I was driving, I was alone most of the time, and I would stare at the clouds. And I loved how ephemeral they were, how they move across the country and the states and the cities and the small towns. So I became really inspired by that. And then the buttons were a way for me to sort of document my travels, almost like ticks, carving ticks on a wall, making marks on a drawing.
I went to Catholic school in my early youth, and it was a punishment for everything he did. And I wanted to express that with this chair. And the title of this chair is A, B, C, D, E, F, U. And E, F, U is my revenge on the nuns. Then we have this tub, which is an actual claw tub. And it's about this woman who has an affair with this guy. After she has her activities with him, she cleanses herself in this concoction that she makes, and she has this bath to remove his scent from her.
Our piece is called Button Rain, and it's a two-part piece, sort of showing the light and dark side of a fantasy character based on Andre.
What were buttons before they were these everyday objects that people have on their clothing? And it's interesting because this was a prompt from Souleo in the research he even sent us, and the whole notion about buttons being this thing that was connected to nobility, class.
And the symbolism of having to be controlled and buttoned up in order to conform to society versus the freedom that you have within, and looking at that as the unbuttoned state, and how these different ways of thinking about identity, that buttoned up state where you control who you really are to fit into society.
And miniature paintings on buttons, that are often portraits. I try to make things, sometimes for my own amusement, as small as I possibly can and fit things in that perhaps someone else might only pick up with a magnifying glass. But again, I'd like to leave that to people's imagination and see if they can find little things that I've put in there.
To me, this represents what really is New York about, New York City. We all come from different parts of the world to just be unique here, and I try to celebrate that with my work. It also, you know, since I've been around, it reminds me the work that Patrick Kelly used to do way back. So I just saw like the whole thing kind of coming together, that there's such a resilience of style and fashion.
I am amazed at the amount of work that these artists put into their projects. Clearly a labor of love.
I really, really enjoy the button show at Rush Art Galleries. And my favorite one was the lady on the wall made out of buttons. I thought it was like super cool.
I love how there's photography, sculpture, mixed media wall pieces. It's just really fantastic. It's such a beautiful range.
My mother always had a small can of buttons that I used to take and throw them all over the floor and play with and match with, and so this button show was a great way to kind of project me back to such a great time.